You already know that you can use sum function to sum the values in a data range in Excel. But how do you sum the values in a range that meets certain criteria? Use this channel to upskill your expertise in Microsoft Excel, Word or PowerPoint. Do subscribe if not done already. Consider that you want to sum only the sales quantities that are in excess of 100 units, or finding out the sum of discount provided for sales that are more than 100 units, or summing up the values of only chocolate sales. In such cases, use the sumif function to sum the values in a range that meet the criteria you specify. The sumif function has three arguments. The first one is the range and is a required argument. This represents the range of cells that needs to be evaluated by the criteria that you specify in the second argument. The range can contain numbers or names, arrays or references containing numbers, or date in standard Excel format. The function will ignore blank and text values. The criteria is the second argument and is also required. The criteria can be a number, an expression, a cell reference, text, etc. You can also include wildcard characters like a question mark to match any single character, or an asterisk to match any sequence of characters. If the criteria include text, logical or mathematical symbols, then you should enclose them within double quotations. Else, if it is only numeric, then you can use them as such. The third argument is sum range and is optional. You need to specify this only when you want to add cells other than those in the range argument. When omitted, Excel adds the cells that are specified in the range argument. To avoid errors, ensure that the sum range and the range are of the same size. Let us understand how to use sumif function via the insert option. Select the cell where you need the sumif value and click on the insert function to the left of the formula bar. On the insert function dialog box, select the sumif function and then click OK. On the resulting function arguments dialog box, enter or select the range that needs to be evaluated, that is B3 to B8. For criteria, enter 200, as we need to sum all the values in the range that are 200. Leave the optional sum range argument as blank. Now you will see the result as 400. Click OK to enter the result on the selected cell. You can see the relevant formula in the formula bar as well. Let us try using the sumif function by directly entering the function arguments instead of using the insert function option. Select the cell, enter the equal sign to begin the formula. Type sumif, open the left bracket, select the cell range that needs to be evaluated, that is B3 to B8, enter a comma. Now enter more than 100 in within double quotes. As we are adding up all values in the range that are more than 100 units, leave the third argument as blank, enter the closing bracket and hit enter on your keyboard. You now have the sum of cells that are more than 100 units. Let us now find out the sum of discount of all sales that are in excess of 100 units. As in the previous case, type the formula, select the cell range that needs to be evaluated, enter the criteria as more than 100. Now, specify the sum range for the third argument close the bracket and then hit enter. You get the sum of discount for all sales exceeding 100 units. Let us find out the sum of sales of only chocolates. Start the formula. Select the range that is to be evaluated. Now this is A3 to A8. Enter a comma. As we need to sum only the chocolate sales, instead of entering the text, let's use the cell reference that can be either A4 or A5. Let's select A4. Enter a comma. Enter the sales range that needs to be evaluated. Close the bracket and then hit enter. You get the sum of sales relating only to chocolates in cell E13. Instead of a cell reference, you can also specify the text here in the criteria. So let's try that. So this is the range to be evaluated. Now, let me enter chocolates in double quotes. Let me now select the sum range and then I close the bracket. I hit enter on the keyboard. You get zero as the result. Do you know why? If you look closely, while entering the criteria, you have entered that as chocolate, but if you expand here and then see, it's actually chocolates. So if you correct the criteria here and then hit enter, you will get the result. Let us understand how you can use the asterisk symbol in the criteria. Say, we need to find out all the sales that relate only to biscuits. As you see the data here, there is an entry by biscuits, another entry by biscuits, and then there is another entry that just says biscuit. So in this situation, let us use the asterisk. So this is the range to be evaluated. I am entering the criteria. I am putting the asterisk mark here. This is the sum range. As you notice, the asterisk symbol takes care of all the instances wherein the string biscui is followed by one or more characters. Let's see how to use a question mark on the criteria. If you use a question mark instead of asterisk, this will bring only a value as 80. Because it considers only one character after the string. That is why the result is different than that of the previous one. While using the SUMIF function, you may encounter the value error in certain instances. One of the common reasons for this error is that you might be referring to a cell or a cell range in a workbook that is closed. To resolve, open the related workbook and then refresh the formula by pressing the function key F9. Another reason could be that the string in the criteria may be more than 255 characters in length. Shorten the string length and that will take care of the error. This is all about the SUMIF function. Okay, but how to handle the situations when you need to evaluate the data using more than one criteria? In such case, you may need to use the SUMIFS function that we shall discuss in another lesson. Till then.